As we listen the sweet words of Krishna Swami Garu, and in the same way we would like to listen your words and understand and make an awareness of the Sri Sampradayam, Sri Vishishtadvaita Sampradayam of our lineage, where the people like you are the protectors of this Sampradaya and reaching this to the next generation with utmost hands. Swamiji, I request you to grace this occasion your sweet words, and I will note down the important points of you and try to translate them into the local language of our Telugu. So feel free to speak with all the attendants here, Swamiji.
Hare.
Hello.
Yes, I can start.
You can start for me.
அந்தமிழால் நக்கலைகள் ஆய்ந்துரைத்த ஆழ்வார்கள் இந்த உலகில் இருள் நீங்க வந்துதித்த மாதங்கள் நாள்கள் தம்மை மண்ணுலகோ தாமரிய ஈதென்று சொல்லுவோம் யாம். This is the verse written by Swami Manavala Mamunigal in his Prabandham called Upadesha Ratnamalai. In this verse, he states why we should all know the importance of the Aalvars, know their Trinakshatrams and celebrate them. What the Aalvars came to do is, in the Ulagil Irul Neenga, the birth of the Aalvars or the avatar of the Aalvars was to remove darkness from this world. Irul means darkness. In the Ulagil Irul Neenga Vandudhitta, the Aalvars took birth to remove darkness from this world. How they plan to achieve that is stated in the first part of the verse. An Tamilal Narkalaikal ஆய்ந்துரைத்த ஆழ்வார்கள். நற்கலை மீன்ஸ் த வேதா, ரிக்வேதா, யஜுர்வேதா, சாமவேதா அண்ட் அதர்வண வேதா. தீஸ் ஆர் கால்ட் நற்கலைகள். கலை மீன்ஸ் வித்யா ஆர் அ சோர்ஸ் ஆஃப் நாலெட்ஜ். நற்கலைகள், தீஸ் ஆர் சுப்பீரியர் சோர்ஸஸ் ஆஃப் நாலெட்ஜ். சோ தட் தே ஆர் நெவர் ராங். தி வேதாஸ் ஆர் நெவர் ராங். தே ஆர் ஆல்வேஸ் ட்ரூ. தே ஆல்வேஸ் ஸ்பீக் த ட்ரூத். Therefore, they are called Narkalaikal. What the Aalvars did was, they took these Vedas and analyzed them. Aindu uraitha Aalvargal. Aidal means analysis. They went through the meaning of the Vedas. All the meanings of the Vedas were shown to them by Bhagavan. We say Aalvars are Mayarvada, Madinalam, Arulapetchavargal. So, they did not do hard penance or some tapas to reach that jnanam. Bhagavan bestowed them with that jnanam and bhakti. Mayarvara, madhi nalam. Madhi means jnanam, nalam means bhakti. So Bhagavan gave knowledge and bhakti to these Aalvars. What they did with this was, narkalaihal aindu. They analyzed the meanings of the Vedas. After analysis, an tamilal uraitha Aalvargal. They gave to us the important meanings from the Vedas in Tamil. An Tamil means beautiful Tamil. It is not hard, it is very simple, it is pleasing to hear, it is pleasing to recite, it is pleasing to know the meaning of those passions. So, An Tamilar Nath Kalehal Aayin Duraitha Aalvargal. Why did they have to do an analysis? The Vedas are telling us what to do. They say what we should practice, and they also say what we should abstain from doing. Then the Aalvars could have just translated the Vedas into Tamil. The Vedas are in Sanskrit, so everyone might not be able to understand them. So for the common people to understand, they have to be told in Tamil. Now, why do you need analysis for that? Our Manavala Mamunigal says, Narkalaihal Aindu Uraitha Aalvargal. What they had to analyze was, in the going times, Kali Yuga is going to start. The Aalvars were born in Dwapara Yuga and some in Kali Yuga. So, all the meanings of the Vedas are hard for people like us to understand. And the Vedas also talk about many things. The Vedas will say do Karma Yoga. Vedas will say do Jnana Yoga. The Vedas will say do Bhakti Yoga. The Vedas will also say if you want to have a child, do this Yajna. If you want to reach Swarga, do this Yajna. If you want to become the next Indra and rule over Swarga for a long time, do this Yajna. So the Vedas don't tell the means to Mukti alone. They talk about so many other things and also talk about Mukti. Therefore, the listener or the one who is reading the Vedas should be so powerful and he should be intelligent that he should be able to remove or get rid of all the unwanted portions and find out what is the crux of the Vedas. Now the Alvars thought that going forward in Kali Yuga, people will not be able to do this. They do not know Sanskrit. They do not know the hard Sanskrit that the Vedas use. They do not know Nyaya, Mimamsa, Shastrams, etc. Therefore, we cannot translate this whole text into Tamil and expect everyone to understand. So what the Alvars did was, they chose only those bits which we will need. For our Mukti, Alvars do not talk about living in this world. Does any Alvar say, if you recite these Pasharams, you can live here happily? There are some Pasharams. Konda Vendir Makkade. He says you can live happily with the family. For those Pasharams, the meaning is that you want Mukti. But till you reach Mukti, you have to live here. For that, you will need a wife who can help you in service. The wife is not just for enjoyment or to go on a vacation abroad. The wife is to do dharma karyam together. She is called Saha Dharma Charini. So a man requires a wife to do dharma together. Without a wife, many things cannot be done. The man alone does not have the qualification to do some activities. Therefore, the wife is to do dharma karyam. The sons are to do dharma karyam. The family and friends and wealth and locked life that we get are all to do dharma karyam, or in the words of the Alvars, to do kainkaryam to Bhagava. Not even for dharma karyam, to do kainkaryam. So, the Alvars did not talk about reaching Swarga or becoming Indra or getting more and more houses or wealth. The Alvars talk only about Mukti. So, they had to analyze the Vedas, which talk about so many different things, pick only what is required for one who wants Mukti, and they translated that into Tamil. So that is what Manavara Mamanigal says. An Tamilal Narkalegal Aindurayta Alvargal Inda Ulakil Irul Neenga Vangudhitta Madangal Naalgal. So by translating or by giving the meaning of the Vedas in beautiful Tamil, the Alvar tries to remove darkness from this world. Now what is this darkness? It is not the darkness that we see during the night. That is removed by just the sunrise. The sun, the Surya Bhagavan is enough to remove that outer darkness. This darkness that Manavara Mamanikal refers to is the darkness that is in our mind, that is in our heart. That is Ajnanam Avidya. So Avidya is the darkness that Swami is referring to here. Not the external darkness, not the absence of light. He is talking about Avidya. Now Ullirul, this is referred to as Ullirul. Ull means inner, Irul means darkness. Inner darkness is nothing but Avidya. This Avidya refers to two things. The word Avidya has two meanings in Sanskrit. One is Anasmani Atma Buddhirya Asve Swamitiya Matiki Avidya Taru Sambhutehe Bija Netat Vibhasitam. This is a Purana Vachana, Pramana Vachanam. What this says is Avidya means two things. One, believing that you are something you are not. Suppose I do not know how to play cricket, but I falsely assume that I am a very skilled cricket player. That is called Avidya. This is what we see in the world. Similarly, we are the servants of Bhagavan. We are not this body itself. The body is different. It is non-sentient. It does not have knowledge. I, the Atma, am sentient. I have knowledge. So I am different from the body. I am a servant of Bhagavan. This is the true nature of the Atma. However, what do we know? We think that we are the body itself. We say, I am fat, I am lean, I am tall, I am white. All these mean the body is white, the body is tall, the body is fat. The Atma is not tall or lean or fat or stout. So, we think that the Deha, the Shariram is the Atma. Or, we think that we are independent, nobody is controlling us. So, all this is called Avidya. When the Atma is truly a servant of God, we think that we are independent, we do not serve anybody. That is called avidya. Similarly, Parashara in Vishnu Purana says, avidya karma samnyanya tritiya shakti rishyate yaya kshetrajna shaktista veshtita nripa sarvaga. He says avidya refers to karma. Karma means papa and punya. We have been doing so many activities in innumerous births. This is not our first birth. We have taken crores and crores of births till now. So now, we have accumulated a lot of karma. That karma, papa and punya, is also called avidya. So, the alvar have to remove two things now. Ul irul, inner darkness, means avidya. Avidya means a wrong understanding about the atma and the punya and papa that we have accumulated. Now, both these have to be removed. What is required to remove both of these? It is important to know this to understand the glory of Periyalvar. Periyalvar has concisely done both of these things. The achievement that the Alvars did was they removed false conceptions about the Atma and they gave us ways to remove our karma. What are these two ways? For the first one, to truly understand the Atma, we need Swarupa Jnana. We say Swajnanam, Bhagavad Jnanam and Upaya Jnanam. There is something called Artha Panchakam. We should first know who we are correctly. Then we should know Bhagavan correctly. We should know what we want to achieve. We should know what are the means to achieve that. And we should know who is stopping us from achieving that goal. So this is called Artha Panchakam. The first of that is Swajnanam. We should first know who we are truly. So if we know who we are, we will remove Ajnanam. We will not think that I am the Shariram. I will know that I am different from the Shariram. I will not think that I am independent. I will know that I am a servant of Bhagavan. So Swarupa Jnanam is required to get rid of Avidya. Similarly, the second type of Avidya, which is called Papa and Punya, what is required to remove that? Bhakti is required to remove that. Krishna says, Janma Karma Cha Me Divyam Evam Yovetki Tattvataha Yakshwadevam Punarjanma Naiti Mameti Sorjuna. When you know the deeds of Bhagavan, when you understand that Krishna took birth as a cowherd, he ran away from Mathura to Vrindavan, he killed Putana, he stole some butter, he ate that, he went and played Rasa, did Rasa Kreda with the Gopika. As you know more and more and more about the birth of Krishna, the qualities of Krishna and the Cheshtitam, whatever activities he has done, more and more you know about this, you develop more bhakti towards him. That bhakti has the power to cleanse our this atma. All papa and punya are removed by bhakti. Shuddha bhavam, dato bhaktya, shastra vedvi janardhanam. This is a verse in the Mahabharata. So as you grow in bhakti, your papa is removed. So two things, inner darkness is wrong understanding of the atma and our karma, papa and punya. To remove the wrong understanding, we need Swarupa Jnana, correct understanding about the Atma. To remove karma, we need bhakti. So these two things are essential for us to know. This is what Periyalvar gave in his two Divyamana Prabandham. The first one, called Trivallandu, tells us about the Jivatma Swarupa. The second Prabandham of Periyalvar Tirumudi tells us about bhakti. It inculcates bhakti in us. What does Trivallandu do? Manavara Bhamanigal says, வேதத்திற்கு ஓம் என்னும் அதுபோல் உள்ளதற்கெல்லாம் சுருக்காய் தான் மங்களமாகதால். He says there are two similarities between Pranava, Omkara and Tirupallandu. The first one is, Omkara is the gist of all the meanings of the Vedas. Omkara, Richaha, Yajurumshi, Tamani, Tateiva, Atharvanani, Sarvam, Ashtaksharantastam, whatever is spoken about in Yajurveda, Rigveda, Samaveda, Atharvana Veda, all that is contained within the three syllable Omkara. A, U, Ma. The three joined together to give Om. That one Pranavaksharam has all the meanings of the Vedas. Similarly, this Prabandham called Tirupallandu has all the meanings of all other Divya Prabandham. So it is called Uldadikellam Surukkai. Surukkam means a gist, a summarization. So Tirupallandu is the summary of all other Divya Prabandham. Similarly, Mangala Madalal, Pranavam is considered very auspicious. When you start something with Pranavam, that is why at the beginning of the Vedas and at the end of the Vedas, Pranava is recited. We start with saying Harihi Om. When the Veda chanting ends, we say Harihi Om. So Omkara is placed at the beginning and the end of Veda chanting. Similarly, Tiruppallandu is placed at the beginning and the end of any Vidya Prabandha Parayana. That is because it is very auspicious. Alvar starts by saying Pallandu Pallandu. So he says long live Bhagavan. There is nothing more auspicious than Bhagavan. So Mangala Chatan to Bhagavan is very auspicious. So it is placed at the beginning. Similarly, the last stanza says, Shudhirum Netsuvar Pallande, again Pallande. So the whole Prabandham talks about Bhagavan existing forever and ever and ever. There is nothing more auspicious than Bhagavan. Pavitranam, Pavitramyo, Mangalanam, Mangalam, the Sahasranamam says this. So, two things. Swarupa Jnanam is required to remove all misconceptions about Atma. Tiruppallandu gives that Swarupa Jnanam. What is the Swarupam of Jivatma? He is a servant of Bhagavan. What should a servant do? He should try to protect his master. The role of the servant, the supreme duty of a servant is to protect his master. That is what Alvar did. He said, Pallandin Kaapidum Paanmayantaal. Sridharangam Sabadanar, he talked about Sri Alvar and said, Pallandin Kaapidum. It is a protective shield for Bhagavan. Sri Alvar utters each and every word and he offers a super kavacham for Bhagavan. This kavacham made of iron or gold is not going to protect. He is going to protect Bhagavan forever. So, the first one he does is, anyone who is a servant should do Mangalachasanam to the master. That is what Sri Alvar did in his first Prabandham. So, Swarupa Jnanam Alvar gives to us through Tiruppallandu. The second one is Bhakti. So, we should know how to inculcate Bhakti in us. For that, he is saying the Sri Alvar Tirumudi. He says, Vittu Shittan Manaste Koyil Konda Kogana. Bhagavan Sri Krishna is always present in Sri Alvar's heart. He is always there in his manas. So Sri Alvar is always enjoying Krishna. He says, Bhogatil Valluvada Pudumayarthon. Bhoga means enjoyment or Anubhava of Bhagavan. Bhogatil Valluvada. I am never devoid of Bhoga. I am always enjoying Bhagavan. So as Sri Alvar enjoys Bhagavan, nobody else has enjoyed. ஆழ்வார்கள் தங்கள் அரவ தரவுதானி கொங்கும் பரிவாலே வெள்ளிப்புத்தூர் பட்டர் நிறான் பெற்றான் பெரிய ஆழ்வார் என்னும் பெயர். ஆல் தி ஆழ்வார் ஹவ் பக்தி டுவர்ட்ஸ் பகவான் பட் தி அதர் ஆழ்வார் ஆல்சோ வாண்ட் டு அட்டைன் சால்வேஷன். சப்போஸ் ஃபார் 10 ஸ்டாண்டர்ஸ் நம்ம ஆழ்வார் வில் திங்க் யூ ஷுட் பி ஆல்வேஸ் எக்ஸிஸ்ட், யூ ஷுட் பி வெல், யூ அண்ட் மகாலட்சுமி தாயா டு லிவ் பல்லாண்டு பல்லாண்டு பல்லாண்டு. ஆஃப்டர் தட் he will start asking for his own mukti. When are you going to grant me mukti? I don't want to live in the samsara. Please take me away from the samsara immediately. So, he looks to Bhagavan, thinks that Bhagavan should be happy or whatever. Then, when he looks at himself, he also wants to attain mukti himself. Sri Alvar never asks about this. Whenever Sri Alvar goes in front of Bhagavan, he only says Pallandu, Pallandu, Pallandu. That is why he is called Sri Alvar. So, his bhakti towards Bhagavan is considered to be more than all the others. Alvar, Sankar, Alvar, Taravudanani, Pungum, Parivade. Alvar, Sri Alvar's bhakti is such that he forgets about himself. When he goes in front of Bhagavan, he thinks only about Bhagavan. Bhagavan came to give darshan to Sri Alvar. Sri Alvar went and said that Narayana is the supreme being. So, the Pandya Raja, the Pandya king was very impressed. He made Sri Alvar sit on top of the elephant and he came on a procession around Madurai. When he was coming, Bhagavan appeared there to give darshan to Sri Alvar. Immediately, Sri Alvar was afraid. He did not have any pride. He did not think, my glory is so great that Bhagavan came to give darshan to me. The immediate thought that came to Sri Alvar was, why did Bhagavan come here? He should be safe in Shivaikuntham. There should be Nananta, Vishwaksena, Garuda and all the Nityasuris should be protecting him. He has come in this Kali Yugam, in this Madurai, in this Samsaram. So he should not come here. I should immediately try to build a Kavacham for him, give a shield for him. That is why he thinks Pallandu. So two things. Periyarvar gave Tiruppallandu to instruct us what is the true nature of the Jivatma and what each Jivatma should do, which is best way is Mangalashasakam, Bhagavan doing Kaitaryam to Bhagavan. When we know the true nature of the Jivatma, we will remove all misconceptions, misunderstandings about him. So, the inner darkness is removed. This is one avidya that is removed. Similarly, when we read Periyar Vastramani, we read about Krishna's birth, we read about how he kicked Shakata, we read about how he crawled on the mud in Vrindavana, we read about how he stole butter, etc. All these shaktism, he says, Unnudaya Vikiramam, Unruliyamalanda, Ennudaya Nenjamambal, Yuvarvadi Yedithikonde, my manas, my hrudayam is a wall. All the chaitanyas of Krishna are painted on that wall like a painting. So they are so clear to me. This is what Periyarvar says. So by reading this Periyarvar ceremony, we too can paint Krishna's chaitanyas in our heart. Whenever we close our eyes, we should be able to visualize Kalinganatham. We should be able to visualize Krishna stealing butter. We should be able to visualize Ratha Krida. This is what Periyarvar does. As our bhakti grows like this, all papa and punya are removed. This is the second avidya. So, through these two prabandham, Tirupannandu and Periyarvar ceremony, what Periyarvar does is, Andhavilar, Narkalehar, Aiduraitha Aalvargal, Inda Ulagil, Irulmeenda Vandhuritha Madangal, Naalgal. He dispels the inner darkness that we have. He removes any misunderstanding about the Atma through Tirupannandu. He removes all papa and punya by inculcating bhakti in us by thinking Periyarvar ceremony. So, this great venture by the grace of Attatri G. S. Swami and by the effort of Srimati Padmaja has to be commended, because these two are very important for every Sri Vaishnava. Tirupallandu and Periyarvar ceremony are enough to take us to Mukti itself. Even without Mukti, they are enough to enjoy Krishna day in and day out in this world. We are going to go to Mukti one day. That is, the hands of Bhagavan is going to take us one day. If we know Periyarvar ceremony, we can enjoy our life. Whenever there is a hardship, take the 10 offerings that Advan thinks about offering garlands to Bhagavan. So, Shantana Malli Deyodu, Shantana Malli Deyodu, Shantana Malli Deyodu, if Bhakti will melt us, it will uplift our spirit. Nothing can make us dejected in this world. So, these two treasures are to be had by every Sri Vaishnava. So the first effort by Srimati Padmaja with the grace of Attachri G.S. Swami and Sri Mohanacharya Swami to teach everyone the meaning and the pasarams of Tirupallandu or Periyarvar ceremony are a very noble effort. It is a great day today that so many of you have gathered. There are more than 600 people in this gathering today. So it is a very auspicious day. It is to be commended, and I pray to Bhagavan Lord Ranganatha and Ranganayaki and to the feet of Periyarvar, not the feet of Periyarvar, that this venture grows and all the people here learn all 6,000 Divya Prabandham. So I also thank Sri Mohanacharya Swami and Srimati Padmaja for inviting me to this occasion and allowing me to take part in this. I felt that there is a connection. Periyarvar is called Periyarvar, so it was apt to see the greatness of Periyarvar through the words of Periyajiyan. Manavara Mamalikal is referred to as Periyajiyan in our Sampradaya. So today we saw the glory of Periyarvar through the words of Periyajiyan. And another connection between them is, Manavara Mamalikal has not written a commentary for any other Divya Prabandha. He has written only for Periyarvar ceremony. So from Manavara Mamalikal's words, we can know only the greatness of Periyarvar and not the other Alvars so much. And again, this year, being the 650th celebration of Swami Manavala Mahamunikal, it is apt to know the glory of Periyarvar through the words of Periyajiya. Therefore, I took this time to, I could have taken more time than was available. I also apologize for the same, and I thank everyone once again, Attachari G.S. Swami, Srimad Mohanacharya Swami, Srimati Padmaja Avankal. I thank all of them for giving me this opportunity to take part in this year. Thank you.
Namaskar. Thank you, Swamiji. Thank you, Swamiji, for your mesmerizing speech for an unlimited time. In spite of that, we forgot the time. Even if you speak 1 or 2 hours, we should try to listen like this only. No doubt in that. Thank you very much for gracing this occasion. Thank you very much for your spending valuable time in spite of busy work with all other online classes from abroad. spend your valuable time with us and grace all our devotees here. Thank you very much. And Padmaja Garu, please speak.
All the participants of the group are quite blessed with the auspicious presence of Srimad Ubhaya Vedanta Pravartaka Sri Pelukkudi Ranganathan Swami for gracing the occasion with utmost love and affection by spending their valuable time with us. In spite of their busy schedule, they have bestowed their blessings by participating and gracing the occasion. Thank you so much, Swami, from all of us. All the ghost members are really, really blessed with your Divya Darshanam and mesmerizing speech, Swami. Thank you so much. Hari and Ramana Chidachi. Namaste, Swami.